goedenavond, bonsoir. De doos die we boven zien, is het de eerste keer in 25 jaar dat die terug buiten komen?
Ja, ze hebben 25 jaar in een stal gestaan, maar veilig zonder koeien. Dus een stal zonder koeien. Dus inderdaad, ze zijn herontdekt, maar Susanna zal daar meer over vertellen.
En na vanavond kunnen mensen nog 14 dagen naar de tentoonstelling komen.
Ja.
Maar er zijn ook nog twee andere films dan Pink Ulysses die we vanavond spelen, die op het programma staan.
Ja, mijn eerste film, Casta Diva. En de tweede, Naughty Boys. En dus de laatste in de jaren 90, Pink Ulysses.
Oké, zullen we dan aan Susanna vragen om erbij te komen?
Ja, en, graag, ja.
Could you be so kind to join us, Susanna, and tell us what did you do to make this happen tonight?
Thank you. Actually, I had to meet lots of friends with this wonderful man, Eric, but with many people who are here in this room. Because I did this project on my own during curatorial studies. It's supposed to be my graduation show, but I have the feeling that it's not completely a solo project because I had lots of help from my friends from curatorial studies, from my partner, from enormous help from Cinematheque in production matters, and of course from Muka, who allowed me to use the boxes from their collection.
The boxes have been restored. There has been work done on them to touch them up.
Yes. So Eric came to curatorial studies with guest lecture, and he told us the story of these peeping boxes, that they are not in the best state. Back then, they were still in Germany, in his previous house, in a stable. And then when the whole process of joining those boxes to Muka started, there was this problem, what we're going to do with images, moving images in the boxes, because they were in an old format, in digibeta cassettes. So this the whole process of digitization of the videos. And that was a little bit surprising because we had many cassettes and we really didn't know which one are the correct ones because it was more than 25 years that those videos were seen and watched, even by Eric. So they're restored.
Okay, great. It's a good tip to say that people after the movie, it's interesting to go and do another tour, even if you have visited it before, and there will be guided tours too, before and after the other films?
Yes, so until 16th of October, there will be, in the days of associated screening program, other Eric's movies, there are going to be guided tours. So then you can ask some questions by me.
All right, I think people are very enthusiastic to see the film. Do you want to thank people?
Yes, I want to thank especially Susanna, of course, for rediscovering these old things. And also, of course, the Muka, especially Lene de Bakker, and a team of the Cinémathèque, of course, with Hilde and Mieke, especially. It's always fine when you have a big, nice team who's working well and efficiently. Maybe I say something about the starting point of this idea of doing peeping boxes. It was just after Pink Ulysses I made this film. And the Dutch, well, it's a Dutch film, like all my film. I'm a Dutch filmmaker, not a Belgian filmmaker, because the money, it's where the money comes from. Who gives you nationality, you know? So the money came from Holland, so I say thank you very much for the money. I make you a very good Dutch film. Okay, and the Ministry of Culture was very happy and say, we want to do, we have to do a big exhibition of young of painters and artists with Germany. We do it together with Bonn and Den Haag. So it's a big project. And we would like that you show your film in this artistic project, this exhibition. And I say, I don't like to have my film showed in an exhibition. All these artists have this different things, paintings, sculptures, and so on. And I have somewhere in a black box where nobody goes once in a while my picture there. That's not my idea of showing a film, a movie. So I say, well, I agree. We do Pink Ulysses in Bonn, but I do a new version of it. I put it in a box and you exhibit the box. And then you have a box with the film in it. It was not the whole film, it was just, because the tape was just 30 minutes, so we had the first box, the Pink Ulysses, which is the first box you see at the entrance. So that was the beginning of my life as an artist. Yeah, my life as an artist. And I continued for a little time. I was very happy. I was not frustrated at all. Maybe because I had no gallery, that things went well. But then a lot of books were written in between, and I had a fantastic agent like Susanna at the time, but she had to go to Hong Kong. So it was not the place where she could continue her work. So I abandoned the idea of making art boxes and these things. So, and now it's rediscovered. So anyway, you saw on the, maybe you saw on the wall, you saw the little things, les bricolages I made when I have a wine box free, I make some bricolage, so some collage too. So that was the beginning of it, of the boxes. And now we have a restored version of Pink Ulysses, again restored by the Dutch. It took a long time, but they restored most of my pictures who were made on 16, like this one, or 35 millimeter. So they restored a lot on digital. If you know all my other films, it's quite different, because all the films I made till then were black and white, very long takes and so on. And this one is totally, I wanted to make a film in color. It was my first film in color. And I wanted to make it not with these long takes and so on, but freely, just like sometimes a home movie. So it, for me, it was, in making the film, it was very different. And because a lot of the scenes were made at home over several months or periods, and then we shot other things in the studio. So it was a mixture, it was really a collage of things and a collage of music and so on. Maybe it's a little heavy because there's so much in it, you know, so much music, so much images and so on. So it's a little like a jukebox sometimes. But the music is by Ravel, the music is by Debussy, the music is by Poulenc, the music is by Wagner. You have a lot of good music. And I think very interesting acting too. So, and it's a story of Ulysses with, I think, a very feminist end. So I will not explain it to you, but yes, I wanted Penelope doing something which I think she should have done in the Odyssey. So it's a little my revenge on Homer. Just a joke. Thank you very much. Enjoy the film.